Sometimes I think the Lord is testing me. Don't wanna go to jail, I'm tired of getting arrested, G. I know I'm sinning when I sell crack, but to a young nigga like me, a G, there ain't no turning back. Trying to settle down is hopeless, with a nagging old lady and a baby I can't cope with it. A chance is something that I never had. I'm standing on this corner, I got my rocks up in a Skittles bag. Can't make a move without my boy. I wear a bulletproof vest and watch my back, cause I'm paranoid. You know the ghetto is a trap. I'm not Tupac, but these jealous niggas got me strapped. Raised like a criminal and born a bastard. Visions of the jail or the grave, a closed casket. Reminiscing about my murdered friends. But I'm proud of selling drugs, supplying my family with these dividends.
Check 1-2, this to the Birdhouse Show. Friday the 13th, I got my man Big German is in the house. I got my girl D, Latifah and Marie is in the house. What's good, y'all? Yo, it's holding the motherfucker out there, man. Man, it's cold, but you know what?
I
heard they looking at some new defensive coordinators. Yeah, I heard they're trying to get rid of my boy.
Your back feet,
cause ain't no bitch nor that kinfolk's ever gon' save me. And if you step to us killers, then you did. Cause I speak with an HK drinking in this infrared.
Another broad ass nigga on this back. And then if it's on your mind, we got that second line back for you.
And for you. What about you and me? Don't fuck with my poo, cause I'd be a bus cap on whoever.
Well, it's a few people. Right, I think,
so the crowd better stop ducking. Cause these no limit true soldiers still ain't finished fucking busting.
Won't be no witnesses to talk about. Mr. Sir, on my life insurance. And I'm about it, pop.
Not on top the way we do this. And bitch, who think they bad enough for parents? Some puss.
So come dance with the devil with the gold. Ain't no butterfly, no lover, if you rest in peace. No one takes 7 days, one takes 7 days. This should be your last day.
The best part is, I can cash out daily with no extra fees. I never have to wait for payday.
It was almost a shutout.
Download the DoorDash Driver app to get started.
Okay. All right.
You know what I'm saying? And, cause like, all right, put it this way.
Wow.
Let's just say we had Jacoby Brissett, right? First, game. Right. And we knew going into it, you know what I'm saying? I mean, he held us down. He did better than a lot of people gave him credit for.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying? I mean, like the talking heads. He played better than a lot of people gave him credit for before he got a chance to play.
Mm-hmm.
Boom. Then, here comes the big ticket guy, right? Sean Watson comes in, and he's not playing that well, but we expected him not to play well. You see what I'm saying? But the thing is, they got rid of Joe Woods because the defense wasn't really doing what they're supposed to be doing. You know, making a lot of mistakes. Bad holding calls and all kinds of shit. But on the offense side of things, let me ask you a question. Didn't we get rid of Hugh Jackson?
Yeah,
we
got rid of Hugh Jackson just because, you know,
you put your boy Baker in, man, and he went straight. I mean, come on. I mean, he was rookie of the year. Shit. There could have been a couple changes that we could have did some things that year with Hugh. And, you know, that just didn't look good. That didn't look good at all.
Well, let me tell you what ain't looking good right now.
Oh, man, this guy.
I just got on my feed from CBS News that by the camera for the show, Odell Beckham Jr. being escorted off a plane after flight attendant raised concerns. This nigga, what is he doing? Pitching me on a plane now? Mm. High Club, the Mile High Club, my bad.
Well, I mean... I wonder what was he doing, though.
Right.
Well, let's see.
But just even further, what was Deshaun Watson doing?
But look here, right. Watson, you know how I feel about Watson, man. As far as I'm concerned, Watson, it's a real
thing. Oh, hold on a second. It's just in. I had to put you on. I had to put you on this shit, dude. Forgot to change our little camera angle. There you go.
All of my dogs got to come and go. If you ain't bought it, then mama know it. I want her patience.
No, I can't lag. It's a set race and I'm in my bag. Niggas who power, they life is a drag. They like black man, I see through the rain.
Really,
young nigga on the brink. I'm just trying to get to the brink.
You ain't breathing.
You
can't do it on the jet though.
Not unless it's the personal one.
And he was in first class.
In this family, we don't kill sheep.
Just pull the curtain.
Okay.
Hey man,
just pull the curtain.
Yo, did you hear that,
Rob, no, we're here.
Yellowstone.
No.
Yeah.
Evil Knievel Son died today.
Yeah.
Yep, lost to a battle of cancer, age 60.
Now that's crazy. All the crazy shit he done did and cancer took him out. This nigga done jumped over the Grand Canyon.
Yep. On an old ass motorcycle too. He's gonna need a crack rocket. He's an old ass 106,000. Then was the what's that shit with what's Mel Gibson? What's that movie? Rogue Warrior motorcycles and shit, nigga. Did you see that last one? The last Mad Max?
Shit
was good. That shit was raw. That shit was raw as fuck. You know how I had the one dude? Actually, the people that had them things on the little truck, that was like,
fuck that. Yo, I wouldn't make that.
That shit was raw, man.
Hey, man, they knew they was about to. That's what they was doing.
That shit was fresh, man. Hey, you saw the dude had the little guitar with the flames going on the side.
I was gonna bring that up. Who wants to do that?
They do, man.
That's all that's
savage, bro. You gotta be a savage, bro.
Ain't no limits to these hits that I make.
Man,
the
man.
He played the guitar since
they
loved the sound.
That was their battle cry.
You rolling. You rocked it.
Hey, you saw the people.
Get back. Crank that shit up.
And the one chick that he was fighting for underneath that truck. Charlie's the one. That bald head chick. Yeah, that shit was raw, man. He gonna be here right here at the MGM Northfield Park, 7 o'clock. That's how we break bread. They keep coming through with this, man. All of this. That's how we break bread. I don't got no problem with mechanic or walling out. I think that is a dope ass platform. I know people that cannot stand and will never watch it. But I have seen a lot of classics on it. Matter of fact, Cat Williams is coming. Did you know that? Pat Williams is coming to the Wolfstein Center. I believe in March. Eddie Griffin is coming. Eddie Griffin is going to be here at 7:30 and 10 on January the 20th.
Who'd you say?
Eddie Griffin.
Eddie Griffin.
Yo.
He'd be funny.
Think about the improv.
Eddie's funny.
He is funny.
His tickets range from $40 to $55. You know, the Improv is only doing four tops and stuff. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I be saying when we go, we always group up. Yeah, we,
I think they got some nice plays coming out.
Do they? You know what? I'm gonna have to look it up. Hold on a second. Wait a minute. Which one?
Eldra. Eldra went crazy. They all pretty.
He got caught.
It just wasn't public now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It wasn't public. And then he came back. I think like the song with DJ, but he did a glam.
I remember. Yeah.
And I was so upset. Yeah. And and it was a tad much for me. I like it, and you know. And
absolutely, but he was. You know what though? DJ Kirk was trying to help him do it.
But that was too much.
Yeah, no, what I'm saying is he was, they look, they got a movie. Did you ever see the Bars movie? It's actually about their older brother.
What's the older brother?
Bobby DeBarge.
Bobby, and then there was
the dude that was in Switch. Remember you said you hated that song?
Oh, you hate Switch.
I'm a man, baby.
You gotta shut up.
You know what I'm talking about? I'm a man now, baby.
Look,
hold on, let me pull it up. Keep talking, German, because I gotta pull it up. I got to.
Yes.
She pulled it up.
Your
and she
went,
no, I hate
it.
My nigga be like, is this your brother? Don't worry about it, man. Shit, just fuck it, man. Shit. I be like, man, I was a little dude when I heard this. And I was like, nah, man, look, I know.
Okay. You was mad at him.
I was mad, like, you ain't supposed to. Nigga, no, man, you ain't supposed to go that. Just fuck it, man. Just take that. Be like, I'm a man now. No, you ain't, man. Look, no. And my girl cranked this shit.
I love that song.
She crank it, and I'll be like, this shit is getting on my motherfucking nerves.
You be just,
nah. Now sometimes I'll be like, no, stop it.
When I'm feeling, stop it. When I'm feeling.
Go to Wix.
No.
Don't even want to see your man. Girl, oh, that's the song.
Yeah, I know.
Yes, we don't own the rights to this music.
I used to think about.
I know you did.
Right, there you go.
Now we're doing it right.
Y'all like shit.
Do you want me? Are you gonna call me?
Yo, I fucking love it.
Is this really your real phone number?
But remember, we used to get fake phone numbers.
I'm a man.
Hold on a second. Wait a minute now. Hold on. Wait a minute. Who is we? But I used to get fake phone numbers.
Right. I wasn't giving them.
I didn't get it. But I appreciate you saying it.
That's her.
Thank you, Becky. You know what I'm saying?
That's coming from her perspective.
Hey, man, I love it, though, because at least we got close. You know how many numbers? I was like, man, I caught that shit like 1,000 times, man.
Oh, I'm
going to write this not the I'm looking when you got that number. It didn't matter. I thought I was the shit. Like, yeah, I got a number now.
Right.
It's my own number, but it's still. It took a lot for me to even speak for motherfucking. Now you know you need space shit. All right. So.
It would use the people who had less stinky breath or something or didn't take care of their personal needs.
I just thought it was because I wore glasses. That was, they were just like, nah. You wore glasses.
So y'all was upset about me having big nose and wearing glasses. I ain't used to it. Or no.
Well, I call your name. No, we'll make do.
Hey, no. dudes be first, though.
Right, I'm about to say, man, I'm trying to stop shit.
Yeah, dudes don't, yeah.
There you go.
Turns out nothing but they collar. You remember that shit? And that's
that was my brother's grandma.
I know. I was just thinking that. I actually wrote that down in my fucking yearbook. It really is the number.
It is. That's my
brother. It's so fucking
is. Like,
oh, hell no. Hell, it really is the number. Hell no. Shout out to Donnell, man.
Hey, Shelley.
What's up, baby? We love you, man.
Little brother.
That shit is funny. Shout out to DJ Gaucher as well.
Oh, yes, yes, sir.
One day, listen to me, man.
Yeah, I just talked to DJ Gaucher.
Right here.
I was hoping to get him down here, but he knows he has an open invite all day, every day. And anybody else
should. Oh, I got, you know, my man Spud coming. You know, I got to get him, you know what I'm saying? I got to get him.
I
got
to get him. My John JT
Tuckley. See? You know what I'm saying? See, we gotta send them invites. We gotta send them invites.
I give an open invite, and I also have a young friend of mine from school who talks about my business.
I wanted to, yep. And also, don't forget, we still gotta get back up to our apartment. We gotta date. I told you, we gotta remote. I'm just trying to get, you know what I'm saying, get everybody to coordinate. I'm gonna get Bob in. I'm gonna get them to coordinate their schedules, but, shit. Hey, look, I'm just going. I brought this up. The main story that's in this video. We was talking about the new mayor. You know, Jim Biden.
Gibbs. Bibbs or Gibbs?
Yeah.
Because I'm thinking NCIS, and it's not that. He ain't Gibbs. He Bibbs, right?
Yep. Okay. But check this out. They're trying to get this. All of the marijuana.
Hey man, and they need to do it real quick. They need to do this shit real quick. Why?
So we gotta get recreational.
Well, not only that, but the house done flipped.
Yeah.
The house done flipped. So everything that we was trying, all the shit that, you know, they were trying to do as far as, up the creek.
And I'm going to give you an example. Because
uh-huh.
You brought up the house. Like so I wasn't even going to go there. Listen to me now. Since the house flipped,
after March of February.
Either way it goes,
it's coming. You know, and let me tell you something.
Better say
I'm going to tell you something. That's why I call your name.
The eggs are like $6 or $7.
They said that the egg, the price of eggs is up 200% from this year. I think of you. Number 8 is like 79 cents, 99 cents. Yeah, shit, the average is like $6 a dozen.
And you better not go to one of these little bodegas.
Yeah, because they run it up.
They can charge you a leg and a kidney.
Yeah. And a kid.
And a kid. Look, you can have one.
A kid and his knee.
Yeah, exactly. But they are also.
I was thinking about getting chicken coop.
Oh no, my neighbors have chickens.
You just come funny, bring that up.
Do you
know how to build a chicken.
She had to design, not build, but design a chicken coop, you know, just for her project. And I'm like, yo, we might have to put this in motion.
Yeah, you might.
You know what I'm saying? Because the way things are going right now, this shit is scary.
It's
scary. You know what I'm saying? So I'm serious about that. And it's going to be an all-year thing, you know what I'm saying?
I'm serious. I'm serious.
I'm letting y'all know it's super serious because where I stay at, my neighbors have a rooster and chickens. And every day I hear this rooster going,
mm-hmm. But you know what though?
But I want one.
You know, you know, chickens lay like an egg a day.
Yeah, mm-hmm. They do.
So if you had like three or four chickens,
you good.
You could also get haircuts or go to a barber, you could have the hair in a net and a stocking and put the hair around your gardens and around your coops and stuff because they smell the human and they don't want to go in there.
Fuck with it.
Yes.
Or just leave a nigga down there. Like
just leave a nigga down there.
You know how you just put them around the thing?
Right, but he might dig that up, so we just gonna take it.
Oh, well.
Yeah, but we used to, you know, people used to come in and get it all the time when I worked at the hair salon. Yeah, they come in and they ask for a hair clipping. So I was like, oh, we ain't doing no voodoo. But they put it in their garden so the rabbits won't eat the food and the deer stay away from it.
Cheap ass,
repellent.
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question.
That's good. I'm serious about that. Yeah, that's good stuff right there.
As you build a coop, you gotta build
new.
Alright,
we'll work on it.
Community
coop. Yeah. I'm serious
about this
farm. Yeah. Yeah, we just need to just get a farm. Like, buy some land and shit.
No, I'm serious.
Share profits and shit. We'll be sharing profits. Do you welcome landslides?
Look here, that's a little bit of water and dirt. I don't ever want to wear boots and shoes to get a lift.
What you do for me, you're ending.
It's getting ugly out here. For real. Like, I, you know what I'm saying? Like, the weather is just fucking shit up. Hey, look where I said this to you a long time ago. Might have been like last year or something, 2 years ago. I asked you this. And I said, David made this up. And they brought it back up again. And I said, Jeremy, what the fuck is the atmosphere here? Okay. You've been to school, right? And you knew about stuff, right? Like, remember you used to hear about stuff like cumulus clouds?
Yes.
They don't. Okay, so now they're making shit up. So they got this new thing. Now you can look at this. It's called an atmospheric river. Okay. Atmospheric river. This is some new shit. Never heard of before. All the years I went to school, all the schools I went to. Now, the atmospheric river is this new thing. So I told you I've been thinking about the first question. They got this new thing now called an atmospheric river. We had the first one about 2 years ago when I first brought it up. Alright? And what it is it's like a huge level of high intense moisture, right? That collects and then it all goes and jumps over the land. Okay? Much like what we're seeing. How did you just come up with new weather terminology when this shit never existed? Like, you know when tornadoes down south? Like, in December, January? Like, you know what I'm saying? all this shit is some new shit. Whisper
in your ear. I'm
sure we got a whole lot of different like, things you can hear. They know something more than what we know. They know something.
I know you won't regret it.
They said one just can't crash it down. They said it had been for like 40 years. It's like, sorry, not sorry.
It's not.
I never seen
that. Really? Never. That's one of the one low budget hood movies I watched besides Shatta and Miami.
Shatta's, okay, right. Shatta's
Shatta's
and
Miami Tale with Trina.
I saw those two. I didn't see them good. Yeah, bro. I didn't see them.
Oh, that was good with Lisa Ray and
Oh wait, yes I did.
Yeah, when she went on.
Yeah, I saw that. And
Regina
Three Stripes.
It's a girl from hold up, I'm gonna tell you where she's from. The Best Man. She was the girl from The Best
Squeak.
Man.
Squeak from The Cosby Show. Wasn't that the girl that was Pam's friend?
Pam's friend.
I
was like, yo, Gang of Roses, I'm gonna check this out. So yeah, you got Lisa Wright, Lil Kim, Stacey Dash.
That's what I'm thinking about.
Stacey Dash, right. She was in Players Club.
Yeah, Monica Calhoun.
Who was she in Players Club?
Monica Calhoun.
Who did she play?
She was the one that got raped.
Right. Oh, there you go.
She was the one that got punched in the face. Cousin?
Right. She is the best man.
That's what I was. That's
the yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah. I didn't know that was her name. Until okay. I pulled it up, I'm looking like, yeah, that's her. That's her.
This so
her.
Was this Diamond's cousin?
Yeah.
That's what I was talking about.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Diamond.
I did cousin. See that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, this ain't bad right here. They really riding horses and shit. I was like,
they
yo,
tried
they had they to put work it. In. They had to put some work in.
They tried it.
Yeah. Who the fuck know how to ride a horse?
Probably you know Lisa, right? We all know how.
Shit. Well, females, yeah, I guess so.
It works just the same.
Same way. Just out there bouncing around. There you go. There you
squeeze
go.
Squeeze your knees. There you make go. Them slow down.
You know.
Pull on the rein.
There you go. Okay, then. All right. There you go. Well, I thought that shit was good.
Yes, it was good.
I thought it was really good. I'm sitting there like, I missed out on this shit.
It was
on YouTube. I had a couple commercials, but, you know, it was cool. Shit, Gang of Roses. So, had to give him a shout out right there.
Damn, I'm gonna sacrifice my Mega Millions tonight. We missed that, Mark. But real quick, I want to go over some of the excitement and television just right now.
Oh, shall we talk about our brother from the West Side, Raymel Adams, starting a new TV show. Got a few movies on Tubi TV.
Y'all oh, yeah?
It? Yeah. Hold on, let me bring him up on my Facebook. Yeah. He's starting a new stuff. And I just seen it. He got some real good stuff, so shout out to him. And he also did the videography for Latasha Spraggan's funeral and going away party.
Oh, wow.
Which was like the club. I'm telling you, it was the club. It was like waiting outside to get in. It was so packed. Her send-off was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see here. I have a... Let's type him in. That's not what we want to do. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's see what he's got going on. He has, because he used to stay right off of on Liberty. That's how we all know him. And y'all, it was Jennifer. They went to school with my sister Jennifer. So he has a comedy show coming up January 21st called Unapologetically. And then he has, what did it say? It's going to be at Old World Tavern on East 185th Street. And then he has, let's see, just showed something about a movie. Has a couple of comedy shows, but he says, where is this at?
You got to see if you can get him up here.
He'll come, definitely. He has this, okay, here we go. Mm-hmm. He's got a new show coming out called Heron Avenue, Season 1.
Well, I want to check that out, just off the title.
Well, it looks like how we would spell Heron, but mm-hmm. It's Heron Avenue. Mm-hmm. So, this is just the...
Okay.
Picture on that.
Okay.
That's tight.
And then, like I said, the movies that he have on Tubi TV, I don't know all the name of them, but he has several on Tubi TV. Trackside Goons. He says Trackside Goons is available on TV. And then he has... It's on Prime. Amazon Prime, too.
Yeah.
Trackside
Goon.
Mm-hmm.
Damn. He making moves.
Call Me 2, The Purge. So I guess it's a Call Me 1, then a Call Me 2. And this is streaming on Momento platform. And then he has the story of Jack Ward.
Damn.
I'm going to send you. Yeah, so he got a lot of stuff coming out.
He got a gang of shit.
Yes, he does. So make sure y'all all get out there and support him and watch his stuff and do it, you know, show him love.
For sure.
And Raymel, you make sure you get your butt up here so you can talk about all your plans and what's going on so we can support you.
For sure, Rep 3130.
That's right.
This big head ass, man.
That's tight.
Oh, did you find him? Uh-huh.
Okay. Yeah. I got him pulled up right now.
Yep. A lot of stuff.
That shit is dope.
Yes, it is.
So check this out, speaking of TV. I just had a chance to check out episode 2 of BMF, season 2. You got to get into it. We'll get into it, you know, in the next couple of weeks when mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, when we're all caught up, when we get some more material out. Mm-hmm. But this is a good time. I was telling you about the Tulsa King on Paramount Plus.
Oh, don't talk about it. I'm trying to wait till I get more episodes because I'm going to have to wait the week to get the new episode.
Well, they're like 8 episodes in.
I know, but that's not enough because I'm a binge watcher. I'll start.
No, but I'm saying like they're like on the last episode now.
Okay, so I watch now then.
Yeah, they ran that. But here's the thing. So Tulsa King, you should definitely need to watch that. It's definitely dope on Paramount Plus, right? Also on Paramount Plus, what you need to watch is The King of Maritime. All right? Season 2 is getting ready to start. So you can binge watch that. Mm-hmm. That first season was 10 episodes of, give me a descriptive word. Intensity.
It was a different spin. On, how can I put it, like, because I never seen a middleman like that.
Right, like street hood politics.
Yeah, and see, because at first you thought that he was respected, but you see, no, these motherfuckers, they still crooked as fuck. It's just, look, it was good. It's tight. But like I said, you never seen the middleman. I've never seen this aspect.
He's like a fixer.
Yeah, or like a...
He's a fixer. It's a problem.
He tried to fix it. Yeah.
No, he really handled shit for real. He handled shit for real. You know what I'm saying? He kept a lot of motherfuckers at bay. Like, you dig what I'm saying?
This shit is good.
And what is this?
The Mayor of Kingstown.
I think I started watching some of that. Actually, it was a black cop and a white cop?
No. Actually, the Mayor of Kingstown is played by...
Hawkeye. Yeah,
Hawkeye. From the Avengers.
Oh, okay. You know what I'm thinking? It's a show, not Bosch, because that's a good one, too.
I know what you're talking about.
But this one, I think it's got a black guy, and it's got a white guy, but it might be like a British gang show, like the Gangs of London or something like that.
You need to check out, see the Mayor of Kingstown.
I'm gonna watch that.
That shit, it starts off dope from the very second it starts. I mean, you have to pay attention. From the very second it comes on.
Okay.
From the start, the very start of that shit is dope. Mm. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm going to watch episode one tonight when I get home because I ain't really got nothing to watch because I was on my little anime kick, you know.
Oh, you know what? It's not a bad start. That shit is good. It's fucked. But also, so you know, his name is Jeremy Renner, by the way. It's played by a guy named Jeremy Renner. Jeremy Renner, as you all know, may have to have his leg amputated.
No.
Yeah, when it was super cold out, real super cold out, he got one of them big, wide, expensive ass, like, snowplow shits. And I think he was trying to help somebody, and I think the plow kept going when he jumped out of it, ran him over.
Wow.
So he's been in surgery, he's been in the hospital and everything. So, you know what I'm saying? He's been kind of messed up.
Oh, that's terrible. Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Y'all keep going.
Yeah, that's
Juice Q, what up? You on the air? You on the air?
I don't gotta run out.
All right, I'll be there.
That's what's up, man. Yep.
I got you, Drew.
Drew, we love you, homie.
Hey, Drew.
Yeah.
All right,
I got you. I'll be there.
Man, that's my stuff about Jeremy. Renning.
Yeah, Renner.
Renner.
Yeah, yep. But you know, we had a few deaths that came by past couple of days. I was telling you about Rob Knievel.
And somebody else just died.
You know, one of the Pointer Sisters just died.
No.
Yep.
And Lisa Marie Presley.
Yep, right. Lisa Marie Presley died.
Michael Jackson's wife.
The drummer from Earth, Wind, and Fire died.
Wow.
The guitarist, Beck, died. They considered him like one of the best guitarists
no
ever.
Way.
He just died.
Right under Slash.
Yep.
Right by Slash from Guns N' Roses.
Wow. Shoot, who else died? This is somebody else.
Real talk, man. Beck makes some shit that you get fucked up to.
Yeah.
Straight up. That's now, you know, like, when I was coming up, there were certain songs that, you know, my peeps would get fucked up to. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Beck was one that they cranked. Like, look, this is what you sit back and you get fucked up to. That's just how it was put to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, yeah. All right, so Beck, that was close right there. Might have to go home and listen to some.
Right, because you know what, we got those certain alternative music songs that our family would listen
right.
to.
Right.
Like Phil Collins, that wasn't mainstreaming us for
it
real.
It wasn't something that niggas was listening
no.
to. Let's just put it like that. It wasn't that niggas, you weren't hearing that. But on the West Side of Cleveland, you did. I mean, shit. What's up?
West Side of Cleveland.
There you go.
So, real quick, on the TV side, we got mixed up with the deaths and announcements and stuff. But you know, John Wick coming back.
Yeah.
John Wick.
I can't wait
coming.
To see that.
Are you gonna watch the Avatar?
No.
Me neither. I was just throwing it out there.
No,
I never liked Avatar. I always thought that there was. Listen.
I found this on the web.
I know that the first Avatar, you know, it was a huge budget movie and all of that stuff, right? But when I watched it, I just was not that amused. Mm-hmm. I know that it looked like, you know, with the computer generated stuff, it was a dumb movie. And now they got part two. And they say that part two, I don't know what they meant, in combination with part one, has surpassed $1 billion. I don't believe that. But, like, I'm just not, I mean, you know what I'm saying? That's good that it could do that much numbers, but I just did not enjoy the first one.
The first one was shitty boo-boo.
I just didn't enjoy it. I thought it was
dry
dumb.
As hell.
But that's just my opinion, you know what I'm
as
saying?
Hell.
Somebody might be like, oh, man, you ain't like that. No.
Mm-hmm. That movie was on the same lines to me as Captain of the Commander of the Sea with, dude who played Maximus.
I know who you're talking
Captain
about.
Of the Commander of Seas, that dry ass water movie.
Yeah.
He was a captain on the sea with the pirates, but all they was on this stupid ass boat. Just stupid.
That's like Waterworld. Remember that
Waterworld was way better than that. Yeah. Waterworld was way better than both the Captain and Commander of the Seas or something. Okay, and then Avatar, the first one, was the graphics and the makeup and fashion was awesome. But the story was so dry, you should have read the book first.
That was dumb. It was dumb. The dude put to sleep. And so his conscience is in this other dimensional world, right? Mm-hmm. But then when he wakes up, it fucks up the balance
of their system.
Like, you know what I'm saying? And then they started to realize that the girl was falling in love with, like, well, to them would be considered an alien because they didn't have humans. You see what I'm saying? And so they try to find some way to breach over into our... This shit was dumb. And I don't know why they made another one. I'm sorry.
Because just like everybody wants another Lord of the Rings, just like everybody wants another this, they had to make another one. And I personally, I'm not sitting another 3 hours to watch these fuckers that's 6 foot tall and this blue makeup do absolutely nothing.
What about Willow?
Willow is pretty decent.
Did you watch the new one?
Yes.
You did?
Yes.
See, I watched the old one.
Uh-huh.
I've been watching.
Because I knew the new one was coming out. I had we watched the old one.
I didn't like the old one. The
old one was, that's a good movie.
I know it was. I just didn't like the.
That was a good movie.
They freak me out. They get under your skirt.
The little people?
Yeah.
I could go with that. But I'm saying,
it was good if you could.
If you can deal with, you know,
that it was type a good story. Fiction, you know what I'm saying? It was a good story. It was a good movie. I just didn't like it.
Right.
I just want to see what this new joint is about, just because they had. I like, just like Evil Dead, Ash versus the Evil Dead. Mm-hmm. I like when you have somebody that did something
with it before
30 years ago, mm-hmm. and then the whole cast stuck with it. Like, you feel me? You know, people grow apart. Right. Like, you know what I'm saying? I like to watch those projects. Because mm-hmm. I told you, Ash versus the Evil Dead was pretty good.
You did.
That's with Bruce Campbell, right?
Yes.
I love him.
Yes.
Yeah. I love Bruce
And you know,
Campbell.
He has a new movie.
What is it, a new Sam Max movie?
He got a new movie with Michael J. White. Yeah.
Michael J. White.
He does. I stand corrected.
Look, he's not my favorite person.
What's the name of that damn movie where he be, they be in a, it's new. Where they be in a, what the hell is it called? I think it's called Black Friday. Because they be in a, it's Black Friday. Because they be in a store. And it's Black Friday, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's like an,
I think I know what you're talking about.
It's like an apocalypse. It's like a zombie apocalypse.
Some crazy, another. Okay. See, as soon as I see these, yeah. like a sidekick of some zombies.
John, I'm going to tell you why I watched it.
What's up?
Because I like Bruce Campbell.
There you go.
I had to. When you're a fan, you're just a fan.
I even watched Xena with him in it. And Burn Notice.
Yeah.
He's awesome.
I think it was Black Friday. I'm pretty sure it was because it just came out. I just watched it like a couple months ago.
So let me ask you guys, are you guys doing Rookie the Feds with my girl Niecy Nash?
I haven't yet, but I plan to because I love Niecy.
I love her too.
I love her.
I want to put my face in her titties.
Was it touch and agree?
Yes, I do, Niecy Nash.
Yeah, yo, did you see the new Snowfall trailer?
Uh-uh.
Yeah, new Snowfall trailer is out. I think we might close out with the Snowfall trailer.
Okay. Yeah, she is fine as fuck.
Fire.
Yeah, she is.
Good Lord.
Fire. Yeah, she is.
She a regular chick like us. You know, just regular nitro chick.
Shout out to Sherry Shepherd and Jennifer Hudson. Both of their talk shows got renewed.
Good.
Sherry Shepherd got renewed Wendy for two seasons.
She
got renewed for two seasons. That's how much they want her around.
She done took over.
Wendy's spot, Wendy Williams. Wendy.
Yeah. Yep.
So, also, if y'all are going to do Worky Feds, y'all got to do the Leverage. Leverage Redemption. I love Leverage.
Leverage. That's a show, right?
It's a show.
Yeah, I know it's
on TV, but they have Leverage, which is part one with the full old cast. But the all old cast came back except for one dude who was the mastermind because he was into that Me Too movement and few people was talking about he was titillating on their titillos.
Oh, you mean in real life?
Yes. So that's why he's not in.
On TV.
On the show, they made him have a heart attack and die, but. Mm-hmm. They couldn't have him back as the mastermind because of his trouble with the movement and all that stuff.
Okay. Okay.
Damn. That's fucked up.
But Leverage. Uh-huh. And it has the dude who played in Black Adam, who was a dark-skinned guy. played in the Slave movies too. I don't know his name, but I always call him Hardison from his character. Fan as fuck.
So you know, also, Neil Long got another movie.
He's fine as fuck.
Neil Long got two movies. Neil Long got one movie on Netflix with Eddie Murphy.
Wait a minute, and she got another movie with she being abducted.
Little girl.
She did looking for and shit off of Facebook.
And now that's on.
I just saw that trailer.
That's on.
I was like, Bergen, oh, he just.
That's
he,
on.
He on this shit.
Is that Amazon Prime?
Something like that.
Yeah, there's a lot of those on Amazon Prime.
Yeah, something like that.
And y'all need to check out Toni Braxton. She got a movie called Only Murderers Book Club.
She do?
Toni Braxton?
For real?
Is she like
acting debut?
No.
Not even real. She's been acting. She been doing
Shit. Yeah, she been doing shit.
Yeah, catch me up.
She be on shit. I gotta kind of like look her up. She be doing shit, but she be like on the old
she's
and Lifetime.
Now. Yeah, but she did this as Lifetime. This is a Hallmark movie mystery.
Yeah. She do stuff like that. Yeah.
She so just got her.
It's a good cuddle of that movie. As soon as you said Hallmark.
No, it ain't a cuddle. It's a mystery, so it's not a cuddle. Well, you and her could watch it, cuddle.
We gonna cuddle.
Oh, yo, I ain't gonna lie. I do want to see that Megan, though. You seen that Megan Trainor? Uh-uh. You ain't seen that Megan Trainor with that dog?
Where she doing her dance? You ain't seen that shit? Well, with it
you
like Wednesday.
Megan?
No, Megan the Killer.
There's a movie.
That's all you're thinking about.
Called Megan.
Uh-huh.
Here, type it in.
Let's pull it up. Let me show you this.
You ain't seen that? I'm not even a scary movie fan, and I done seen Megan do the dance.
Yo, and actually, they said that shit is blowing up, too.
It really is.
It came out last week, and that shit is everywhere.
And I just had two of my girlfriends go and see it, and they said they really enjoyed it.
And I know Bob wants to see it. Bob got a thing for the girl, because she be doing a little...
The Wednesday
my little brother,
dance.
I know Bob. Bob wants to see that shit. Watch, I'm telling you.
And so now check this Megan out, y'all.
Yeah, check it out. Yo, so check it out. Just the new joint, Megan. Let me get this over here right quick. Give me 2 seconds.
Ah! Right. That's me. You'll be scared as fuck watching one of them shits with me.
Blumhouse, give it to you. Oh, I know. Alright. I seen this shit. Yeah.
She looks like everybody I know named Megan.
Megan start killing folks. Yeah, I know what's up with Megan.
Teenage Chucky.
Right. Pretty much.
But I swear she looks like every girl I know named Megan.
It's the modern day Annabelle. So you know that's the chick from Get Out.
Mm.
You hear me, John?
Mm-hmm.
That's the chick from Get Out, the girlfriend.
Did you see the look on this doll face when she said, turn off? He deserve everything he got.
Oh, yeah.
Watch how she run.
Look, Germ.
I love Jern. You don't want to miss this part.
You sure don't. Nail gun.
Yeah, boy. Ah! Yeah, I seen that shit. I know what y'all talking about now.
Hell yeah. So, boom. I'm going to head on and pull up the Snowfall trailer, y'all. And, you know, we got a list of homework that we got to follow up with until the next week.
I'm trying to pull up this movie I watched on Netflix. It was so damn stupid. It was so damn stupid. And the reason why I watched it is because it was filmed in Ohio. It was filmed in Ohio. I'm going to tell you who was in it.
Is it The Killer in Ohio?
No. The Devil in Ohio, that was good. I watched that. It was a series.
I watched that, too. Ohio.
I told you to watch this.
Hold up.
This movie
I know what you're talking about. I just watched it.
This movie was with Don Cheadle. Andre was in it. Remember when
Andre
3000. Yeah, Andre was here. And there was a little quick picture that he took. He was down in the flats. He just took a random picture with some idiots. And they blew him up. Like, look who's here. And Andre was just like, in the back. He like photobombed they shit. It was Andre. That's what he was doing. He was filming this shit. It was him, Don Cheadle, the dude who played Dark Vader in the Revenge
of Sith. Oh, man, I can't stand that.
That tall dude, you know what I'm talking about? Anyway.
You ain't talking about Tick. He wasn't in none of that, was he?
No.
Okay. Because I was about to say, you cannot dare say he wasn't out Tick.
But, man, this movie was so damn stupid. It was so damn stupid, man.
So you said Andre 3000 was in it?
Andre 3000's in this bitch. Yeah, Andre was in it.
You see the new trailer, though? They about to kill this nigga. Look, Jern. Yeah.
Why he looking like Samuel Jackson in Pulp Fiction with that hair on?
Yeah.
I'm gonna need them to get a better Jerry Curl Soul Glow. They could have got that hair that was his face off ER used in the Coming to America. They could have got that wig and put that on that man's head. They could have got him a better soul glow. What's this?
That's Breaking Bad.
Oh.
And Better Call Saul.
Yeah.
I like both of them shows.
There's a running joke in our house about Better Call Saul. Oh, no, Breaking Bad. My sister was having issues, and we was talking about how to fumigate your house from, like, just fruit flies or stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
My grandmother's 90 years old. She gives her, like, these three things that you need to go and buy from the store, and then you put them in a sardine can and burn them. I said, bitch, she gonna have your ass making meth. You gonna be Breaking Bad. Don't you gonna be on the do not fly list.
No.
Don't go listening to your friends.
Hell no.
I'm telling you.
Excuse me. Well, on that note, I had a little fun, but it's time for the man's to run.
Man, hold on, man. Before we leave out, I wanted to show y'all this stupid ass movie.
Oh, yeah. Did you find it?
You don't never text us. We need to make a whole group chat.
You know,
so I'm lazy.
Back. I was sick as fuck. Wait a minute. Hold up, man. Because it came up on Netflix and it was like number two.
So where's your continue
you said
watching.
Number two.
Yeah, it was like number two.
Oh, you talking about most trending?
Yeah. Man, you know I can't find it.
Let me see if I can help you out right quick.
It was stupid as fuck, man. It was...
I didn't know Andre 3000 was on a movie on Netflix.
Yeah, man. Andre was in this bitch, man. I was shocked. I was like, yo, it's Andre.
Okay. Right now it says number two is Vikings Valhalla.
Yeah. This was like last week.
Oh, man.
It was last week, and shit ain't even up here now.
Well, then this is what you got to do is when you go to your Google, type in last week number two most watched or last week number two rated on Netflix. Let's see what that gives you.
Or just type in Andre 3000 movies. Was it White Noise?
There you go.
Okay.
Hell yeah. That shit is stupid as fuck.
Now, I did see, I didn't know he was in that. And I don't like Adam Driver.
And that's when him, look, man, that.
I don't like Adam Driver. Oh, he does, God. He's not a Darth anything to me.
Let me see who Adam Driver is.
He the new,
is Darth Vader.
Darth, not Darth Vader, though.
Oh,
it's Darth,
yes.
Darth
Seth. Darth Lord.
Darth Sith.
The, yeah, whatever. Yeah, so.
Oh my! Wasn't he? You sure he didn't do Young Vay? No, he was the son or something of somebody. I seen this.
He was on the Hope, the one with the Finn, the black
dude. Oh, he looks much better with facial hair, I'll tell you that.
Well,
I've seen all his stuff.
This shit was...
What was the movie about? I think I saw the trailer.
It was an explosion. It was an explosion, right? And they started freaking out because it was... The shit, it never happened before, right? They didn't know how to handle it. So they was just like going through, like it was a whole bunch of like, what do you call that? Hysteria. People start just making conclusions up and shit. Like, oh, the toxic is in the air and it's going to make us all do this and do that. And they was just going crazy. But the way they was doing it was so damn stupid. It was like they couldn't, they were smart. These people were extremely smart. But their logic and how they thought about this shit was just way over the top. And you go, man, that's what this whole movie is about. Like, they would every situation they looked at,
they overcomplicated it.
Every fucking thing. No. And you go,
and you have to watch it to the end.
I'm watching this shit to think, what, why? Okay, because it has some good actors in it. It was like, okay, Bird, look at this, right? It was another, with a whole bunch of good actors in it. What was that stupid ass movie called? Hold up, I'm gonna tell you what it's called and shit, because it was Cutthroat City. You ever seen that? Had a whole bunch of good actors in it. This shit was stupid as fuck.
Wasn't Cutthroat City like based off of the old that Sin City comic?
No. Cutthroat City was on Netflix.
Hold on.
That had Wesley Snipes, Shamar.
I don't think I finished that, and it's very rare I don't finish a movie.
It got Tick on it.
Did it have Tick?
No, it didn't. It had my boy from Wu-Tang Saga. Matter of fact, Wu-Tang Saga Season 3 about to come
out. I'm about to say, man, since you brought up the Wu-Tang Saga, because that shit is broad. That shit is...
There's a new one coming out.
I can't wait, man. I can't wait.
Terrence Howard?
Yeah, Terrence Howard
was yep.
in Cutthroat City. Right. He was in Cutthroat City. Cutthroat City had a lot of good actors
in it. Yeah, it did.
This is why I watched it. Because, you know, man, I can't believe y'all signed on for this. Same reason why I watched White Noise.
You know what I think, though? I think they might have been giving a young...
Directors.
A young actor or writer a shot. You know what I'm saying? They might have had some incentive to believe in this.
Okay.
It didn't seem like it was done by a seasoned... It seemed like somebody had...
Millennial
some
dreams.
Privileges that were extended to them. Like, okay. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I don't know why, but maybe somebody... was somebody's son and just fuck with these people or something. But it seemed like it was a favor for a friend, kind of like.
Well, look at this, right? You know White saying? Noise. White Noise, they put a lot of production into this shit. A lot. And it was so damn stupid.
Now, you see, M. Night Shyamalan got some movies.
Yeah, but see, his shit be...
He got two movies coming
shit,
out.
Right. His shit, I've seen the trailers and I can't really think of them.
I can't think of what the name of them are, though. That's the thing. When you said White Noise... What you're describing sounds like one of the M. Night Shyamalan trailers, but it can't be. I don't know.
Nah. I haven't seen a Shyamalan. Fuck this name up. I haven't seen one of his movies that wasn't thought provoking, that you didn't have to like really look at, figure some shit out.
Did you watch Old?
With them on the island?
Yeah.
Nah, that's good.
You need to watch that.
But it was good though, cause I haven't watched it yet. But I know it's good.
Yeah,
I know that shit is good.
That shit is good.
When I saw it, it seemed like it just wraps everything
well,
up in the trailer.
But you know what though? You but what it was stupid though. That's the thing about M. Night Shyamalan though.
See,
his movies, Davey, that's what it is. Mm-hmm. He never has a way to really bring them home. Like they be good in theory, but they be dumb though. Like you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like that old. Is the movie is good, but it has a dumb twist to it. So they always have a dumb twist.
Uh-huh.
What's the one when the trees were when the trees blow and the motherfuckers just start
killing themselves? It was the pollen. It was the pollen.
Okay, I understand that. Yeah. Okay, now here's the thing: the same way that this, I can't spoil all for you.
Mm-hmm.
On that movie, right? Mm-hmm. We had that. So why did they have to shoot the black kid's face off? They had nothing to do with what they were tripping over. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? See, and he does that. The theory of the movie be good, right? But then he just be having shit that don't got nothing to do with it. It just don't got nothing to do with it. You know what I'm saying? So, it does, though. That's how it all was. You know what I'm saying? The movie was good. But then you're like, but why did... And I can't tell you, but you'll see when you see it, you'll be like, but what that ain't had nothing to do with it? Like, you know what I'm saying?
I'm going to tell you this about White Noise. You don't need to watch that shit.
No? I'm going to take your... No, that's Andre 3000. Though, see? Look, I love Andre 3000.
Look, I love Andre, too.
That's my boy, man.
But...
It was a bad...
It ain't, no, man. Look, and I love Don Cheadle, too.
Me you know what, though?
Don Cheadle is my boy.
I do love Don
Cheadle.
He
is an awesome
Don
Cheadle
is my boy, man, for real.
He'll make you think he is anybody and everybody
what?
Like Lawrence Fishburne.
But guess what? Great acting in the movie. The movie is stupid as fuck. You watching this shit trying to figure out, why am I watching this? Serious. You going to look at him and be like, why am I watching this movie?
So, mm-hmm. What did you think about The Fresh Prince? And how far did you get?
I watched all of The Fresh Prince.
What did you think about it?
I love The Fresh Prince.
The one with the new
remake. That shit was on point. And to me, it was like, okay, check this out, right? They didn't have to do this. And to me, it's like, I don't know who is putting this behind. Like whose idea to bring this back? Was it? Because to me, they shitting on Will Smith.
Remember I told you? Let me tell you what. I'm going to tell y'all.
Go.
It was a fan-made. Okay. A long time ago. When I told you a long time ago, it was a fan-made movie. It was like a fan-made. You know how people make their own fan-made trailers?
Yeah, those fan.
Of
those
what could be. So it was fan-made. A fan that fan made a concept. And in this concept, it was like, but both of the Aunt Vils had both came home. Okay. But it was serious, though. And they had this whole thing where they had this thing pitched where it was like, it was the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, but they had to try to explain what the fuck was going on with Aunt Viv, because it was both of them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, it was supposed to be like real kind of like serious combative soap opera type shit.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? But in this context, you only saw one Aunt Viv in a room at the time, but like the rest of the family, they couldn't tell the difference by looking at her. But it was like, you see what I'm saying? So the dark-skinned one was trying to shit on the light-skinned one's life.
Okay.
You feel me? And from there, they expanded it to what we have now, this show. That's how it was. It was like, say, one of the comedy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And so they adapted that story, and they really made it into this show. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So it was pretty dope, because I brought it up before it was a show. When I had showed you and Bob a long time ago, like, look at this shit. They made this theory, like, what if Aunt Viv, like, the other one came back and was like, who is this bitch? Like, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And they had this whole thing where it was like two and three different trailers to this thing. And then Will Smith actually adapted it and, you know what I'm saying, reached out to the people and they redid this shit.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why it's like, it's not, it's pretty interesting.
Because, like, when I see... I don't know the actor's name that does Will Smith, that does The Fresh Prince, rather, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's not supposed to be a comedy, but they make fun of his gestures.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, his head thrown back, mm-hmm. or he'll roll his eyes and say, you know how Will Smith would
right.
do that shit.
Right, some of the stuff that he would do that
right.
would be
right. It's like they only doing that shit to show...
How corny
you was, nigga. And right. it's you just watch it and you just kind of laugh at that shit.
But we also have to understand, when he did that, that was the fucking 80s and 90s.
It was.
Your head back and
right.
rolling
all
your
that.
Was tough.
But now they're bringing it back. And it's just like, look, even though that was you, they still trying to shit on you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, all right, it's cool. Will Smith can take that. You know what I'm saying? Because that's just real.
First.
If it wasn't for Will Smith...
Half of us wouldn't have half the shit we have.
Right, a lot of the shit on TV would not be where it is.
Not even TV. I'm gonna take it one step further. If we didn't have Real Smith, a lot of us wouldn't be able to do the party music that we do.
Mm-hmm.
Parents just don't understand. Girls of the World, fucking every fucking year. As soon as first day of summer come, I'm expecting to hear Summertime.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't play it, you fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
But he did rap without having to use all the cussing, all the dirty words, making a bitch be up in his face like this. Mm-hmm.
So why you gotta do my nigga Frankie Cass like that, man?
Hey, that shit was funny as fuck. Did you saw that shit on the that shit was funny as hell with Terrence that nigga Terrence Howard told nigga, keep my wife's name out your motherfucking mouth, nigga. That shit was stupid. You gotta see the best man final.
Yeah.
Cause that shit was on there. When that nigga said that shit, I just broke out laughing because this shit, it wasn't supposed to be said. It wasn't supposed to be said. He just brought that shit in there. You know like, what? I'm gonna throw this shit in here real quick.
Let me. I also gotta mention this. I started to mention it before, and I think I went off on a tangent. So this whole Neil Long shit, the Eddie Murphy movie. Did you see the trailer that's supposed to be on Netflix for, damn it, Jonah Hill got a movie on Netflix, right? Eddie Murphy and Neil Long, they're supposed to be like, you know what I'm saying, married, and they have a daughter. I think the daughter is played by, I want to say Nuno. Might be Nuno. Might, I think it is, I'm pretty sure it's Nuno.
Okay.
Now, Nuno is supposed to be dating Jonah Hill. You know who Jonah Hill is, right?
Yeah.
Right, and they're getting serious, and Jonah Hill is trying to talk to her parents about like how serious they trying to get, like you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So it's a lot of people in this movie though. Now I don't, a lot of the jokes is kind of racy,
mm-hmm.
racy double entendre, mm-hmm. racy and racy. You know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? But when you look at the cast though. He got a little bit of everybody from the black comedian side. They got a little bit of everybody from the white comedian side because they do like family functions, I suppose, in this film. And so, what's her name? Julia Dreyfus.
Elaine.
Now you know how she's big time, big time comedian.
Yeah,
she's on there. Jonah Hill's on there. A couple other, you know what I'm saying, Caucasians that's, you know what I'm saying, funny. And then you got the black side, you see what I'm saying? So it's a little bit of everybody on that motherfucker. So, you know, I don't really like Jonah Hill or some of the joke contexts, it's all like that. But it's Eddie Murphy, though, dog.
That's probably
I gotta
why.
Watch
that's
everything
why,
Eddie Murphy, you know what I'm
so
saying?
He might be better with Eddie Murphy than he is with Channing Tatum and them.
Yeah. You got a point.
You know, because he's working around people who... not only can give a joke, they can take a joke.
Mm-hmm.
They like a good roast. So, you know, it could be like, why you ain't, you know, don't make me sweep the legs from out under you when you're talking to somebody who ain't got no legs, you know?
Yeah.
They can take that shit. Where on the other hand, don't you
What's
up?
You rolled your eyes at me like this.
No, seriously. Like, look, Jonah Hill, most of the shit that he was in, I laughed at.
Did you watch Sausage Party?
It was classic white boy humor.
You watch Sausage Party?
I saw,
what did you think about it?
I thought it was different.
I thought it was not for your kids.
Hell no.
No. The offer up, you know,
hell no.
When it said Sausage Party.
But Sausage Party, that shit was just so damn funny with the food and whatnot.
Like,
yo,
what if my food really acts like
that?
That
shit was
asleep?
Funny as fuck. I was laughing my ass out there. Like, you taking me? I'm going. Like, I'm leaving. I'm going to the land beyond. I'm like, y'all really thinking this is all fucked up? Who thought of this shit? Because you sitting here watching it, you go,
like me with this in their hands.
Like, man, this is some silly shit right here.
What if
this
bun started talking to us, dude? What would the hot dog say to the bun?
That was funny. That shit was funny. All of that shit, dude. We're gonna be together and all this. Yeah, nobody get smashed, man. That shit was stupid.
Hey, did you see some of them were gay?
Yeah.
What was it like? Was it like some nachos? Or
I can't
some
remember
shit?
Who was gay, but I know it was.
It was like
it
a nacho
girl that
bag
was gay.
Or some shit.
It was a girl that was gay. That was chasing somebody.
Yeah.
She was chasing somebody like a motherfucker in the whole movie. She was like an aggressive lesbian. Aggressive. You know what I'm saying? She was like on that shit. I can't remember what it was, man, but she was highly aggressive. That shit was funny, man.
It
I like that
funny,
shit.
Though.
I thought Sausage Party was different. It was funny. Clever.
It was definitely a get high movie.
Oh, yeah. Off rip.
I've watched it a number of times. All right, that crew. That always sticks together.
I'm about to say, man, that's the pothead crew right there.
Yes.
That's the pothead crew.
You know what it is? I'm going to tell you how I felt about it. I thought that it was somewhat funny, but some of the jokes are a little bit like...
white boy humor.
Yeah, there you go. That's the best way to put it.
It's white boy humor.
That's the best way to put it. Some of it be like, you like, no.
Well,
this
we find
saying.
It funny, but
I'm not saying don't watch it. I'm not saying it's not
wonderful.
Funny.
It's good.
I'm just saying some of them jokes they be a little bit over there though. You know what I'm saying? You be like, man, these motherfuckers are off the chain.
See, like when you say,
but I watched it more than once though. Don't get me wrong. You know what I'm saying?
So like when you say white boy funny, I instantly think of some shit like Seinfeld. This is me. That's like,
no, she's not talking about Seinfeld type.
I'm talking more of,
she's talking about
boys,
white boy humor, like
Jackass.
Jackass.
Okay.
Or
right.
Or
over the top nonsense.
Okay. Impractical Jokers.
Yeah.
That type of funny.
My wife loved that shit.
Right.
Like,
where?
See, like, I'll be sitting there watching the
shit.
Like,
I'm gonna say, what's up,
babe? Stupid shit. They do some stupid shit on that show.
Oh, trust me, I know.
Yeah.
Dave had me watching something.
It's Caucasian humor because if you tried that stuff and ethnic humor, you might get effed up.
Yeah.
We look at things a little different.
We sure do.
We think
you're not going to sit up here and ask me to touch your meat, and I'm a man.
You know what I'm saying? It's a little different. It's a lot different.
It is. It really is. So that's why I say it's that type of humor, like frat boy, white boy humor.
We don't chase each other's balls.
Exactly.
You my nigga.
Goofy,
man, but,
stuff like that, but
right.
And that's what I mean.
I ain't gonna try and hurt you.
No, man. I'm not gonna. They don't think
that hurts. They just think it's funny.
They be putting like crab shit on their nipples and shit.
Let's try and light your fart on fire. Like, yeah. Come on, man. Whatever the fuck you smoking, you need to go and take that back. Because if you got me wanting to light my asshole on fire.
Hey, you remember the one dude used to fuck his father up all the time?
Yeah.
Bam.
Yeah.
Hey.
Didn't he pass?
I think so. His dad did, didn't he?
Well, I think it was one of them. I think it was Bam.
Damn.
Let's see.
I think the short dude. Didn't the midget?
The midget too. Let's see where he at. He
I thought Bam fell out with them. And yeah. He tried to sue them.
They all fell out.
He tried
out.
To sue them.
Why did... Getting slapped in the head so much, now you coming to senses?
When I first seen these motherfuckers, I was like, man, is this real? Yeah, it was real. They was doing some stupid shit to their parents.
Hey, You know what? I'm going to tell you what. I watched the first one like this. Like,
wait a minute.
Then
Shoe got to get picked up.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, they don't get out till. All
right.
You know what I'm saying?
I ain't know when. I was like, look.
They close at 12.
All right.
They don't actually get out until like 12:20. Yeah, man. I watched the first one. I watched the second one, right? But you know they had a new one that came out, right? I kept 5 minutes, Jerm. I couldn't do 5 minutes.
This new Jackass.
I started it. Nope. Stop that shit. I'm cool. I'm not. That's not my style.
He's
at
still
all.
Around.
They always do that, man. They push that envelope though. I don't be into that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It be like that gay humor though. Like they be trying to do some funny
that.
Shit.
We can't say that.
Well, I'm sorry.
It's
I don't know what
Caucasian
to say.
Caucasian humor.
I'll go with that. It'd be Caucasian humor, bro. And they'd be way, way over there with that
yeah.
shit, man.
You know, we can't say it's gay because all gays don't do that type of shit.
You're right.
So
no, and actually, I didn't mean that. That's what gay people do.
Right,
I mean,
that's how
I mean,
take it.
They act gay. I don't know if they're gay or not. They make... They pretend to be gay with
no,
each other.
Gay people don't act like that. With
but
each
what
other.
I'm saying is, they. But what I'm saying is, they. That's what they, that's their humor. They pretend to be gay in order to harm each other and embarrass the other person. Put it that way. That's what I mean. I'm not saying they act like somebody else.
No.
But they be doing stuff with each other's stuff though. Like you
yeah,
know what
that's
saying?
Homosexual activity.
Bruh. That shit ain't funny, man.
But homosexuals don't do that.
Why y'all always gotta play with each other's
that's
genitalia.
Caucasian humor. Homosexuals ain't always feeling on each other's balls, and because we gay, we don't just touch and grab on your shit. We don't do that. We really don't do that. Like for real. They don't kick it like that. If we messing around, then we touch on each other. But the closest gay people do is they'll be like on RuPaul Drag Race and read.
Yeah, I never believed that gay people acted like that.
No,
I went to St. Anne's though, and that's how they act.
That's
what I be talking
humor.
About. When I be saying that's what
right,
I be talking about.
That's the
about.
Caucasian humor. Where
yeah,
where
I be on that, bro.
Like, dude,
Yeah, no, that ain't funny, man.
Right.
We don't even, you know what I'm saying, play like that. Like, you know.
Frat boy humor.
That's just my style. Mm-hmm. My style's hot style. Your style's no style. Get it? You know, what's that? The originator. You know what I'm talking about? That's Jay-Z.
Yeah, Jay-Z's ass.
Yo, until then, you listen to the Birdhouse Show. We're going ahead and get up out of here. Yes. Get you all other perspectives, sides of the world. You know what I'm saying? We had to come together like Voltron, like we do.
Do your homework next week. I am the Latino. No, that's one of the Hooker Twins. Powers activate. That's right.
Big germ. I'm glad you came out. Y'all know what's holding the motherfucker down here, man.
It's all right. That was Cleveland.
Found my keys. Down here.
We good.
You know what I'm saying? So we good. We Gucci. So I'll be here tomorrow on Sunday. You know what I'm saying? I got to get some more preparations together.
Yep.
A few more shows lined up.
All our guests reach out to us that we offered an invite to the show. Please reach out to us.
And help us grow and expand. This year we're looking to expand. You know what I'm saying? We're going to look to expand.
Most def. I can't wait till summer so I get out my comfies and get in my skivvies.
Okay then. All right then. What we doing?
We doing
that. Oh, yeah. One last thing. Did you see the house party trailer?
I'm not. That shit is horrible. Bold.
But you saw it, right?
I'm not fucking with it.
You saw it?
Yeah, man.
A little bit of everybody.
Are they having kid and play?
Yeah.
Immature?
I don't know about immature.
Was it immature ones that did the last?
But here's the thing. Let me slow you down for a second. This is not a kid and play house party. This is a LeBron James house party.
Remake of it.
And LeBron James was not alive when House Party came out, mind you. Okay? So.
Really?
No.
No.
We that old.
Yes.
No, LeBron is that young.
We that old.
No,
that's what
LeBron
I'm saying.
Is that young.
Shit.
Come on, Jerm. We were still in Marshall when House Party came
right.
out.
Right. We were still kids going to the movies.
We were
real.
Still. My mother took me to see that, man.
Shit. House Party.
Yeah.
He watched this shit on.
Right. We were still in Marshall when that came out.
Right. We wound up getting a DVD.
Nah,
DVD
it was
DVD
like 90, 91. 91. 91.
Right. And he has to be around the same age as my sister. How old is LeBron? 30-something?
Maybe.
Because my sister is 30, and that's her most favorite person in the whole wide world, like Keith Murray, the most beautifulest thing.
Oh, just
thing.
Like that.
Yeah.
Just
but like look, that. It got to do, just the dude, you saw The Shy, right?
Yeah, yes. I know what you're talking about.
The dude that was hustling the shoes.
Yeah, pretty boy.
It's him. Some I forgot who the other cat is. But you know how they be showing like a lot of scenes real fast? This is kind of like, remember Cannonball Run? Remember the movies like Cannonball Run with Burt Reynolds?
Yes.
And they had like this huge all-star cast.
Right, where it was like a
trailer. A million cameos. Yeah.
A cameo movie where everybody has a part. Just well, like a Cheech and Chong movie. Everybody has a part.
This is Kid and Play is a cameo in this.
Oh, that's it.
And everybody else. Everybody.
I saw Weezy.
Yeah.
Oh.
Weezy. Weezy F, baby.
And I was just like, man, fuck this. I'm not watching it.
I don't know if it was Little John or Snoop or.
I don't want to sit.
And you know what, though? It seems ironic, though, that it's always the same people.
That's what?
That be in these movies.
Well, I'm going to watch it. You know what? I'm going to watch this shit.
Did you ever notice that? It's always the same people.
They got to eat, though.
They don't got to eat, bro. They already ate. They eating, bro. They ate everything in sight. Are you kidding me?
So is this house party 4?
Didn't want to leave when you said you out of mustard.
This is going to be house party 4?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
No, house party 4 is immature.
Immature is house party 4. No, this is just straight up house party.
Okay, because they don't
it's
have
it's not
it.
A sequel.
This 2023 ain't
even,
film.
I don't even think this ain't even a New Line Cinema movie. This is a Brian movie.
Okay, I see. This is okay. Let me watch this trailer real quick. Is it gonna show or not? This video has been restricted.
You ain't missing nothing too much, but I mean,
and that's terrible when a TV holics tells you you ain't missing much.
There you go. I'm about to pull it up right here.
Please do, cause I want to see.
Yeah.
Cause it ain't coming up for me. It's like fuck that.
Yay! All
right.
Yay.
Bam.
Bam.
Oh, it is New Line Cinemas.
Thank you. That's our boy from Raw Bounce, ain't it? No, they ain't.
Yeah, they did.
No, they ain't.
Yeah, they did.
I hope they sit them down. I hope my girls come back and sit them down.
I think she was on here.
Check it out.
You gonna check it out?
Hell yeah, because I just seen everybody I liked in there, and I want my girls to sit them hoes down. Put them 50-year-old legs to work.
You see what I'm saying?
We got about a few more get down loads with us with them knees. So I hope they set them down. I hope they shut them down on up in there. It might not be too bad, but that's not something I go sit at a theater for.
Mm-hmm. It's shit, I sit on my couch.
I will sit there and I'll represent and I'll stream and I'll talk, but
there you go.
I couldn't sit in that room with that because I want to be loud with that movie and be like in it, and I don't want to be disrupting everybody. Peace.
Yo, on that note, we're going to get up out of here, y'all.
We're going to watch it here all together.
Oh, right here.
Right here.
Yo, we could have an outing, though. It is a movie theater in here.
Okay.
In this building.
Well, then we can figure it out. Let's do that then.
I'm going to start bringing a little USB drive with some shit on there. Listen to the Birdhouse Show. Check us out next week.
Go home and
week.
Make love to your wife with this. You know, when you go home and sing that to her, she going to do like this.
She going to get home and be like, they was clowning you, huh? I'm like, yeah. They
I'm telling you the truth. When you go home singing that to her, she going to pull it off like, hey, baby.
I'm like,
broadcasting from the beautiful Orion Plaza.
No.
Downtown Cleveland.
I'm glad.
Yo, Jern, this one's for you.
Thanks, homie.
Until then, man. Check us out next week. Thank you for joining us. We'll be here. I'm going to send a shout out. Plug your show.
I am the Latania Marie, tongue in cheek. That's tongue, the and sign, and cheek. On Spotify, on Pandora, on Stitches, on Anchor, on Google Podcasts. And when you look and you have to put tongue, the and sign cheek, and that's me. I am the Latania Marie. Be a guest, tune in, send your info to Jay's show, you know, and we'll get you on as guest. Y'all two need to get on as guest because you got too much to say.
Whoa,
you be having too much to say, and we need y'all. We need your
you don't like how you put me on blast, like you.
Because like you. You've always had a lot to say. Where Jeremy be like nice about it, you. You for the streets. You be leaving it for the streets.
No, I appreciate you.
But I love it. I appreciate y'all.
All right, thank y'all. We love y'all.
Peace out. I call your name, girl.
Ah, get over there.
Go in there and walk in and singing that to your woman. She gonna
be. We need to do some push-ups, man.
Who, you?
This mom, this is sick.
Oh, he need to do this falsetta.
Sick, I'm my damn Miss Crank this shit.
Yes,
she know I hate it. She know I hate this shit.
And she letting her falsetta play.
She know I hate this shit, man. I but look, I'm gonna get home and fuck with that toast.